After the Second World War, the Canadian government started to realize that there was a refugee crisis occurring in Europe. And a lot of humanitarian organizations, labor unions, were sort of demanding government action. And so the government realized that it also needed people to sort of populate the land, but also in several industries, agriculture being one of those. So in April 1947, the Canadian government created the Displaced Persons Movement. And over the following 6 years, approximately 200,000 individuals, displaced persons, came to Canada. They were selected based on their previous skills, their employment background, perhaps whether they were married. They were also selected based on having no past criminal record, no national security concerns, and also of good mental and physical health. The transatlantic voyage for a lot of these refugees and displaced persons, of course, varied, but in a lot of cases, you find for example, in our museum collection, in some of the oral histories that we've done and the stories that are included, that they came with very little. Oftentimes, it was one or two pieces of baggage, maybe a little bit of money. Oftentimes, they had left 6 years of a homeland that was devastated by war. And so they're coming to Canada hoping it's a land of opportunity, hoping that it's a land that will provide them with safe haven. But in a lot of the cases, they're actually coming with very little. So the arrival experience for a lot of post-war refugees and displaced persons was one of newness, of trauma, of being sort of displaced, having to come to a new country with unfamiliar surroundings. A lot of these individuals, of course, came with very little, had very little belongings, oftentimes didn't speak a word of English or French, and so they really depended on the helpfulness and the generosity of not only the volunteer service agencies and the representatives here at Pier 21, but also the Canadian customs officers and the immigration officials, who in some cases were actually veterans of the Second World War themselves. And so they understood, having seen sort of the social and political climate that a lot of these refugees and displaced persons were coming from. And sometimes they would help out by maybe, providing a few dollars here and there to help a refugee or a displaced person purchase food, maybe top up the money necessary or the money needed to buy a train ticket to Montreal. So they were very conscious of the place that the political refugees and displaced persons came from and tried to help them as best as possible. So now I'd like to read the recollections of one Canadian customs officer who actually welcomed and screened political refugees and displaced persons through Pier 21. Canadian customs officer Arthur J. Vaughan, who was stationed at Pier 21 from 1945 to 1965, remembers that the arrival of the displaced persons brought scenes in stark contrast to those of the cheerful, chattering war brides. It is difficult to comprehend what those desperate souls had endured through man's inhumanity to man. They came with almost no items of value, their few belongings were carried in stacks of various kinds, and a few battered cardboard suitcases. These people came from many walks in life, farming, industrial trades, merchandising, and in many cases, professional fields. The ravages of war had taken away their homes, their livelihood, and in too many instances, their loved ones. They brought their skills with them and a burning hope for a new life, devoid of oppression and deprivation. As may be imagined, there was little work for the customs staff, and we knew that we would be working merely as aides to help them through the required procedures.